फंडामेंटल्स एंड इंट्रोडक्शन टू द शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोदम विच इज अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ एल्गोदम्स। सो वी हैड ऑलरेडी सीन रिलैक्सेशन स्टेप एंड इनिशियलाइजेशन स्टेप। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोदम। इट्स प्रॉपर्टी, टू प्रॉपर्टीज आर देयर। सो इट्स सिंगल शो शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ एल्गोदम एंड वॉट इट कंप्यूट, इट कंप्यूट टू थिंग्स। वन इज दैट देर इज अ डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ईच वर्टेक्स, फॉर ईच वर्टेक्स फ्रॉम अ सोर्स नोड। सो इट फाइंड्स आउट दैट डिस्टेंस फॉर ईच वर्टेक्स फ्रॉम अ सोर्स नोड। देन इट ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट्स रिलेशनशिप, पेरेंट चाइल्ड रिलेशनशिप, दैट इज पेरेंट और प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ ईच वर्टेक्स। देन वेदर इट कैन कंप्यूट नेगेटिव वेटेड एज एज शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ। यस, इट कैन कंप्यूट द वेट विथ नेगेटिव एज वेट्स। वेदर इट कैन डिटेक्ट नेगेटिव वेटेड साइकिल। यस, इट कैन डिटेक्ट नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल्स। इट गिव्स ट्रू इफ देर इज नो वेट साइकिल्स एंड दैट वर्टेक्स इज नॉट रीचेबल फ्रॉम द सोर्स। एंड इट रिटर्न्स फॉल्स इन केस इफ दैट देर इज नो सॉल्यूशन एग्जिस्टिंग। मीन्स वेन देर इज अ नेगेटिव एज साइकिल, नेगेटिव साइकिल इज देयर, तो नेगेटिव साइकिल कांट बी कंप्यूटेड। सो इट गिव्स फॉल्स, मीन्स देर इज नो सॉल्यूशन पॉसिबल। एंड इट गिव्स ट्रू एज वेल वेन देर इज नो नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल। मीन्स ऑल द वर्टाइसेस आर रीचेबल फ्रॉम द सोर्स नोड विथ सम फिक्स्ड शॉर्टेस्ट पाथ। नेक्स्ट वील डिस्कस स्टेप्स ऑफ बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोरिथम। फर्स्ट इज कॉमन दैट इनिशियलाइजेशन स्टेप, मीन्स वी सेट ऑल द वर्टाइसेस एज इंफिनिटी एंड वी कीप सोर्स नोड विथ जीरो। वी इनिशियलाइज सोर्स नोड विथ जीरो डिस्टेंस एंड वी सेट पाई मीन्स पेरेंट ऑफ ऑल द वर्टाइसेस, रिमेनिंग वर्टाइसेस एज नल। मीन्स नो, वी डोंट नो हु इज पेरेंट ऑफ हुम। देन द एल्गोरिथम विल बी एग्जीक्यूटिंग फॉर द नंबर ऑफ वर्टाइसेस माइनस वन, मीन्स नंबर ऑफ पासिस वुड बी वी माइनस वन, देन मॉड ऑफ वी माइनस वन, देन ऑन वॉट, ऑन ओवर द एजेस ऑफ द ग्राफ, मीन्स ऑल द एजेस ऑफ द ग्राफ, एंड एजेस कुड बी सिलेक्टेड इन एनी ऑर्डर। देन इन ईच पास, मीन इन ईच फॉर लूप एग्जीक्यूशन फ्रॉम लाइन टू टू फोर। सो यूल हैव लाइन टू टू फोर एंड यू हैव दिस रिलैक्सेशन स्टेप, मीन्स दिस वन। एज वी डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस क्लास, दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एंड द सिंपल रिलैक्सेशन स्टेप। वील सी नेक्स्ट। देन आफ्टर दैट दिस इज फॉर द नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल डिटेक्शन। सो दिस फॉर लूप इज फॉर द नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल डिटेक्शन। वील सी लेटर दैट हाउ दिस बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोरिथम वर्क्स व्हेन वील सी द एग्जाम्पल। सो दिस इज बेसिक एंड वेरी सिंपल एल्गोरिथम फॉर बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोरिथम। वॉट इज टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी? सो इट्स सिंपल दैट इनिशियलाइजेशन वुड टेक ऑर्डर ऑफ वी, देन फॉर लूप वुड बी एग्जीक्यूटेड वी ऑर्डर ऑफ वी टाइम्स, मीन्स दिस होल थिंग विल एग्जीक्यूट वी टाइम्स, देन दिस थिंग विल एग्जीक्यूट ई टाइम्स। सो दिस होल रिलैक्सेशन विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड वी क्रॉस ई। सो वी क्रॉस ई टाइम्स वुड बी एग्जीक्यूटेड। सो एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट क्रिटिकल स्टेप एंड आफ्टर दैट इट्स ओनली ई। सो वी क्रॉस ई इज द रनिंग टाइम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी, दैट इज वी से दिस वी टाइम्स ई। फॉर लूप इज टेकिंग ई, आउटर फॉर लूप इज टेकिंग वी, इनर फॉर लूप इज टेकिंग ई, एंड होल थिंग विल टेक वी क्रॉस ई। देन दिस इज सिंपल, वी प्लस वी डॉट ई, देन प्लस ई। सो ऑर्डर विल बी वी डॉट ई। देन नेक्स्ट द बेलमैन फोर्ड एल्गोरिथम। सो द सोर्स नोड इज बीन इनिशियलाइज दिस विथ जीरो एंड ऑल द वर्टाइसेस आर बीन इनिशियलाइज विथ वॉट, इन्फिनिटी। देन वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू डू, यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट प्रेडिसेसर, मीन्स पेरेंट ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर वर्टेक्स। मीन्स वॉट शुड बी द पेरेंट ऑफ टी, what should be the parent of x, what should be the parent of y, what should be the parent of z. We find that and we follow the Bellman-Ford algorithm. What was given? We have to execute 5 minus 1 passes over the edges. So first thing, we have to choose any set or any random order of the all the edges, means all the edges. This contains all the edges. What are the number of edges? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Means 10 are the number of edges. You can count. These are just 10 edges. We have selected all of them. And how many times it will be executed? 5 minus 1 means 4 times it will be executed, this whole algorithm. So first we will start with tx. What is tx? This one, 5. So infinity plus 5 will give you infinity. Nothing could be changed. T comma y. Infinity plus 8 will give you infinity. And nothing you can reset. Tx. So this t and x. T and z. So t and z is minus 4, you can say. Infinity minus 4 will give you again infinity. X comma t. What is x comma t? This x comma t. This infinity minus 2 means you can't do anything related to that. Why? It's very simple that infinity minus 2 will give you infinity and you can't do anything. So t, that x t would also go on. Y x means y and x. Y x. So infinity minus 3 would also give you infinity. Y z. So y and z. This one. So infinity plus 9 will give you infinity. Nothing could be done. Zx. What is Zx? Zx. Z and x. So this one. Infinity plus 7 will give you infinity. And you can't compare infinity, infinity. Then Zs. So Z and S. This Z and S. So infinity plus 2 will give you infinity. And it's means greater than 0. So 0 is the best one. We keep this 0. And then next, what ST? What is ST? This one. This. So it gives 0 plus 6. What is 0 plus 6? It's 6, which is lesser than infinity. So 0 plus 6 is lesser than infinity. So we cancel this infinity and we replace d dot t. What is d dot t? It is wait for t, vertex t, from reaching from source node. And we set it as 6. So it's very simple. Now, the last one is s, y. So this s and y. What is 0 plus 7? It's 7. And 7 is less than infinity. We remove this infinity with what? 7. This is what the first pass B. This is what is the first pass B. You have made this and this. This is what you have done. You have 6 and 7. Then there is a third pass we'll calculate. How we calculate it? So we come over here and we'll see in this graph. We start executing T comma X. What is T comma X? This one. Now you have 6 plus 5. What is 6 plus 5? 11, which is lesser than infinity. You have 11. Then t comma y. What is t comma y? This t comma y. 6 plus 8. What is 6 plus 8? It's 14. And 14 is larger than 7. So we keep this 7. So 7 will be kept. Then next, t comma z. What is t comma z? This one means 6 minus 4. What is 6 minus 4? 6 plus minus 4. It is 2. So this will result in 2. And what is that next? Xt. What is xt? This is xt. 11 minus 2. What is 11 minus 2? It's just 9. And 9 is not good enough for that. What? T. So you don't reset T. You keep this 6. 6 is good here. Next, after x t y x. What is y x? This and this. 7 minus 3. What is 7 minus 3? It's 4. 7 minus 3 is 4, and 4 is less than 11. So you reset it at d dot t. You reset d dot t, d dot x. You are resetting d dot x as 4 over here. D dot x means y x. You have done till y x over here. Then y z. What is y z? Y and z. This 7 plus 9. 7 plus 9 is like 16, and 16 is much larger than 2. You don't do anything and you group 2 over here. The next z comma x. What is z comma x? This 2 plus 7. 2 plus 7 is 9. 9 is greater than 4. Then you keep this 4 as it is. Then z comma s. What is z comma s? Z s means z could be reachable to the source node in the better way. So yes, we agree something like this. So we say that 2 plus 2, what is 2 plus 2? 4. Is it 4 better than 0? No, 0 is the best one. Means you can reach the source node with 0 distance. So you don't update that source node, and you keep this as 0, and you don't do the 2 plus 4. Means 0 is better. Now st, this s and t is 0 plus 6, it is 6. You keep it as it is. Then s y, what is s y? S y is 0 plus 7. 0 plus 7 is 7. You keep it as it is. Next step. So in this, you have created this one. What you have created? This thing you had created. In just the last step, what you had created? This step, this thing. This is what 2, 2. This is what 4, 4. This is what we had done. And two passes are gone. What are the number of passes remaining? So it's four passes. So now we have two passes left. What we want to do? We want to do again this step. Tx. What is Tx? This Tx. 6 plus 5. It's again 11. 11 is not good as compared to 4. Then ty. What is ty? This t to y. 6 plus 8. It's larger than 7. You don't replace 7. tz. What is tz? This. 6 minus 4. What is 6 minus 4? It's 2. You keep that 2 as it is. Then x comma t. X comma t is 4 minus 2. Oh, 4 minus 2. It gives you 2. Means 4 minus 2 will give you what? 4 minus 2 will give you what? Simple 2. It will give you 2. And here is what is there? 6. Now you think that 6 is better or 2 is better. Now you'll get that 6 should be replaced by 2. And you keep and rewrite d dot t, d dot t as 2, as 2. So this d dot t is being updated as 2. Now next, what? Because of x and t, you have done this x and t. This y x. What is y x? Use y and x. This one. 7 minus 3, 4. Means same thing. Y z. 7 plus 9. It's means 2 is much better, so you don't disturb it. X comma z. Z comma x. Z comma x. Z comma x. This one. 2 plus 7, it's not better than 4. So you give 4 as it is. Z comma s. What is z comma s? Again, you check 2 plus 2, 4. And 4 is not better than 0. You keep 0 as it is. S comma t. This one. S comma t. Now you see that 0 plus 6. What is 0 plus 6? It is 6. Whether this 6 is better than 2? No, 2 is much better. So you keep this 2 as it is over here. So, because 2 is better than 0 plus 6. Why it happens so? Because this is a negative weight. This is negative weight and this is negative weight. And these negative weight had impacted the whole thing, minus 3 and minus 2, and it set this as 2, which is better than 6. Now the next is s comma y. 0 plus 7. What is 0 plus 7? It's a 7. So you don't disturb it. We had completed with this step. Means there is three paths we have already got. And what we had discovered in this path to this path, we had discovered that parent of all these things nodes, that these are the flow of the shortest path. And this is what is being created. Now the last and the final path, fourth path, because we have to run for loop only for 4 times. It again works t comma x, 5 plus 2, nothing will be done. 4 is better. T comma y over here, 2 plus 8, 7 is better. T comma z, 2 plus minus 4, it's 2 plus minus 4. Oh, what is 2 plus minus 4? It's minus 2. So what you want? Minus 2 is much lesser as compared to what? 2. So you replace this 2 with minus 2. So you replace this 2 with minus 2. Why? Because this TZ will result into 2 minus 2, 2 minus 4. 2 and minus 4, because it is minus 4, negative weight is there. So because of this negative weight, you are getting this as even lesser price. Means d of z would be minus 2 in this step. D dot z would result into minus 2, which is better than 2 that we have got in the last step over here. The next step, t after tz. What is xt? Xt, what is xt? This x and t. 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 will result in 2. So you keep this 2 as it is. Then next, y x. What is y x? This y and x. So y and x, 7 minus 3. What is there? 4. So you keep this 4 as it is. Then y comma z. What is y comma z? This y and this z. So 7 plus 9, what is 7 plus 9? It is much larger than minus 2. You keep this minus 2 as it is. Then you have what? Z comma x. What is z x? So this z comma x, minus 2 plus 7, it's not better than 4. So you keep this 4 as it is. Then you have what? Z comma s. So this z comma s, source node again, 2 minus 2 plus 2 minus 2 plus 2, and it will result in 0. So you either you can this 0, you keep this 0 as it is, because it is also giving you 0 result. So both the things are same. 2 plus minus 2, 2 minus 2 is 0 again. So 2 minus 2 will be 0. The next, this st, what is st? This 0 plus 6, it's 6, and 6 is not better than 2. So you keep this 2 as it is. Then s comma y is 0 plus 7, which is again good enough. So you keep it as it is. Now what happened in the fourth pass? This thing was being created, and the weight of this one was being updated over here, minus 2. This is the, so this is what we had created. And when you execute the another pass, means when you execute this for loop again, means you had executed 4 times this for loop, and now you are going to do it the fifth one. This one would be fifth. 4 to 5, the same thing you are going to do fifth time. So what will this, after E you are doing F. So F was not going to change, means F would going to be as it is, means there will be no change in any of the edges, means there will be नो चेंज मीन्स दिस विल नेवर हैपन, मीन्स वी डॉट डी वुड रिमेन द लीस्ट, मीन्स वॉट एवर वी हैड फाउंड विड रिमेन द लीस्ट एंड इट विल रिटर्न यू वॉट ट्रू. वाई? बिकॉज दिस एग्जाम्पल वॉज बीन सेट, मीन्स इट विल गिव यू रिजल्ट. यू जस्ट दिस इज अ होमवर्क दैट यू एग्जीक्यूट द अगेन वन पास ओवर दिस होल थिंग एंड यू हैव टू रीच दैट ई इज इक्वल टू एफ. मीन्स देर इज नो चेंज, देर इज नो चेंज बिटवीन ई एंड एफ. मीन्स ई एंड एफ आर द सेम एंड एफ एंड ई आर द सेम. सो वॉट इट विल गिव यू, देर विल बी नथिंग विल हैपन. दिस एग्जाम दिस रिटर्न फॉल्स विल नेवर एग्जीक्यूट एंड यूल गेट ओनली ट्रू इन दिस एग्जाम्पल. सो इट विल रिटर्न ट्रू, दिस ट्रू विल बी रिटर्न. इट मीन्स दैट देर इज नो नेगेटिव वेटेड साइकिल, मीन्स देर इज नो नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल. सो विल सी वॉट इज नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल. दिस एग्जाम्पल इज अ सिंपलर वन बट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इवन कॉम्प्लिकेटेड वन, नेगेटिव वेट साइकिल.
So, sir, can you repeat for the false and true condition?
Yes, I'll repeat. Till now, this E step, what is E step? Till this E step, you had executed four times, four passes you had executed because of this for loop. So this thing had been executed four times. Okay. Now you are doing the same thing, this relaxation. This thing, same thing, means this thing was repeated over here. The same thing means you are going to do it for the fifth time. You are getting my point. You are going to this thing fifth time. What are these steps? These steps are actually something like relaxation we had seen. So this is fifth time you are executing. Means you are creating F, another F you need to create. Means in this example, it is not given F because F is the same as this one. Means E and F are equal. You run this, this is a homework for you. You run all the 10 edges like I have executed for going from A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E. You execute it again by yourself. You will get there is no change in E. Means E will remain as it is 2, 4, 7 and minus 2 and 0. That's it. So it will never execute this statement. What? False statement, because this is never going to be yes, means this is not never going to be true. This statement is always false, means this will be always less, means v dot d, whatever we had got in this, means d dot t is 2, d dot x is 4. So it will going to be least whatever you do with all the edges order of these 10 times you execute, re-execute it, it will lead you what? This will never happen. Means this will never happen means this will also never happen. So what it will return in the end? It will return in the end true. So this algorithm will say, what does it mean by true? We had already know that true would be returned when there is no negative weight cycle, and it will return false in case of when there is no solution exists. We have to see example for negative weight cycle. I'll show you in the next example, then you will be clear what is why here we are getting E equals to F when we'll not get that E equals to F in some other example. So this is the same example with some graphical or some better that graphics. So we have the same set like this one. We start executing first pass. You keep on executing all these 10 things. So this is actually 10. You counted 10. What do you have to do? Pass one. So you have done pass one. Over here all these things you have done, you set it as infinity, you set this as infinity. Now you start running pass one, you find that after this statement you find that first change S6. After this, you again in this step you also find some change as 7. Now the first pass is completed, second pass, after this all these things T comma Z. What is T comma Z? This, you get here change here, 6 minus 4 will set to be 2. Then again Y comma Z, Y comma Z over here, Y comma X will be changed. 7 minus 3 will be 4. This whole thing would be created in the third pass, before the third pass. So in the third pass, after this, X comma T will be changed. This X comma T, what is X comma T? This has resulted in some change. Then after this whole thing was been done, and fourth pass, you will get what? This thing change. T comma Z. This T comma Z over here, T comma Z, T comma Z, this thing updated. Now just think that if you executed another pass, you will get the same result. Now we have to understand how many times, what is the complexity, cyclomatic complexity or the running time complexity. How many times we had executed? 10 times this. And what we have done? We have done 4 times. Means what is 4? 4 is simple 5 minus 1. What is 5 minus 1? 5 is the number of vertices. What is 5? 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 into all these things at S10. How many times? 40. What is 40 over here? Just think. 40 is the number of times you attempt to do relaxation. So this is the 40 times in this example, particular example, you have done 40 times relaxation. This is what it means by cyclomatic complexity, or that big O, or whatever the running time, worst case running time. So this is what is 40. So O of, this is what O of V cross E. What is V over here? V over here is 10. And what is E over here? No, what is that number of, what are the number of vertices over here? It is simple, 5 minus 4 times execution. What is 5 minus 4? It is 4. And what is E? E is 10. And in the worst case, it would be 5 cross 10. This is what it means. Means in exactly we find that it will run for the 4 times, but here we have 5 cross 10. This is what it means runtime. Then specifically the case we'll discuss negative cycle. You'll get understanding what does it mean by negative cycle and how the Bellman-Ford algorithm help over here. This, when you perform test extra V minus 1, means extra step. What is that extra step? This one that we were discussing. When you do the extra one of this, then you'll get what? True or false. Now we'll see what? With this example. How many passes it requires? It requires only 2 passes. Pass 1, pass 2. Why? Because there is only 3 vertices over there. So 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 passes are required. So how it will start? It will set 0 plus 2. What is 0 plus 2? It's 2, which is better than infinity. It will replace with infinity. So infinity is being replaced with 2. So infinity is being replaced with 2. This is what it means. Next, what do you want? You want again running this edge. What is 2 plus 3? 2 plus 3 is 5. 2 plus 3 is 5. 2 plus 3 is 5. Now 5 minus 8. 5 plus minus 8. So 5 minus 8. What is 5 minus 8? It is 3. 3, 5 minus 8 is 3, 5 minus 8 is minus 3, sorry, 5 minus 8 is minus 3. Now, minus 3 plus 2, what is minus 3 plus 2? In the next phase, next pass, you can say minus 3 plus 2, what is minus 3? So, in the first pass, you had completed all the three edges one by one. Now you had completed first pass. Now you want second pass. In this pass, you have this, this, and this. So minus 3 plus 2, what is there? That it will result in 2. Minus 3, 2, it will result in minus 1. Minus 1 is better than 2. So you replace 2 with minus 1, 2 with minus 1. Now minus 1 plus 3, which will be 2, which is better than 5. So you replace 5 with 2, 5 with 2, because minus 1 plus 3 will give you 2. So you replace 2. Next, 2 minus 8 will be 2 minus 8 will be minus 6, which is better than minus 3. So you replace minus 3 with minus 6. Now you had completed with Bellman-Ford first for loop, first part. Now you perform the extra test. What you are doing to do? Third pass. You are going to do third pass. Third pass. So you want to do this third pass. What you do? You do this whole thing one more time. When you do this one more time, you will find that D of V is actually greater than all these things. Means D of V, whatever you had calculated, is not the minimum one. You are getting even minimum than D of V. How? This D of B is minus 1. Now you run again the same thing. Minus 6 plus 2. What is minus 6 plus 2? Minus 6 plus 2 is minus 4. So you are getting what over here is minus 4. What was there earlier? Minus 1. Oh, you are getting minus 4 as minus 1 as greater than minus 4. Means actually minus 1 is greater than minus 4. So this false will be executed because this condition was being true for the first time. So this is true in this condition and it will return you what? False. This means there is an existing of negative weight cycle. What is negative weight cycle? This whole thing results into negative weight. What? How? This 8 minus 8 plus 2. For this, because it is simple graph, so you can calculate it. What is minus 8 plus 2 plus 3? So it's like minus 3. So every time you keep on doing the one more pass, you keep on reducing. Means you keep on doing all this, means again and again and again and again cycle, you will reach minus infinity. Means S will become one day minus infinity. This will also become minus infinity. And this will also become one day minus infinity by doing n number of passes. Means you keep on doing, you keep on getting shortest path every time. And all the node will have the minus infinity as a result. And minus infinity is the least, you can assume, the shortest path. So not minus infinity is like, it's not, we can't deal with that. Minus infinity is like, you need to be Ramanujan, and Ramanujan is the one who knew the infinity. So minus infinity don't make any sense. Every time you keep on executing this cycle, you have minus 3 involved in the whole step. I hope this is very simple thing. Next, the question is that can the shortest path contain cycle? Can the shortest path contain cycle? In case of negative weight cycle, no, it's not possible to contain negative weight cycle because we had just seen an example that it is not well defined. With every iteration, whatever you do, it keep on reducing the shortest path till it will not reach minus infinity. Minus infinity is the least number possible. So the every time you keep on iterating it, it will reduce the whole cycle cost. Then for the positive weight, can there will be a positive weight cycle? No, it's not possible, because path is a tree. Path is a tree, and tree do not have any cycle. This is property of tree, that even if there is a positive weight cycle or negative weight cycle, cycle is not possible at all. Means cycle can't be possible even in the case of negative weight or positive weight, because this is what, this is a tree, path is a tree. And how you can calculate if there is a positive weight cycle? So you just remove that positive weight, means removing that cycle, you can calculate shortest path. Means it's, if it is a shortest path, then you can remove the cycle by the same concept as we have seen in the minimum spanning tree. We have seen a very well proof in the minimum spanning tree that cycle is not possible at all in the minimum spanning tree, because cycles are not allowed. Then zero weight, in case there is a zero weight cycle, means minus plus, minus weight is there, plus weight is there, in that case there is no reason to add them at all. So you just remove and ignore them, and that zero weighted cycle, and you proceed with the algorithm. Next we'll see the shortest path directed acyclic graph. So it's again the single source shortest path. For the directed acyclic graph, first we have to understand what is directed acyclic graph. So this is directed acyclic graph, means there is no cycle at all. How it will look, any graph with directed acyclic graph DAG would be plotted like this. Means whatever be the there, that you can have this, and you can have this also allowed, this also allowed, because this will not create any cycle. So this is how it will look like. This is just an example for a directed acyclic graph. So now you have cleared with directed acyclic graph. Now what you have, simple again the initialization step, which is very common. Then after initialization step, you have this algorithm for doing the, for each vertex with the topological short, you keep on doing what, relaxation. And how, because it is already been shorted, you just execute it for the first time, and you have only order of E required over here. And the whole, means this topological short will actually require V plus E, which is the most cost expensive. So the cyclomatic complexity or the runtime is V plus E. Then it's very simple. We'll see example over here. So this R is, we set again initialization 0, infinity, 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 infinity. Then we see S. So after this S, we have this R. R is not reachable. First R was being set, and R is not reachable from S. So it will remain infinity as it is. Then we go for the second node as S. So S having 0, so 0 plus 6, what? So all these edges was being explored, 2 was being explored, and 6 was being explored. So it is giving like this. The next step, you explore this one, T, you explore T, whatever be the T. So you explore this one, you explore this one, and you keep on comparing whether this is minimum or not. You are getting, till now you are getting whatever you have done, you are getting minimum. But when you do this 6, you explore this 6, what you'll get, you will get that this, there is, when you explore this 2, then you'll get this this thing. Means when you explore this 6, then you will find that there is possibility of minus 1 to reach 5. Means there is possibility of this reaching with 5. So which is, 5 is better than 6. So 6 would be removed, replaced with 5 over here. Because when you explore 6, you will get minus 1. And 6 minus 1 will give you 5. then when you explore this, you complete with y, you will see minus that 5 minus 2 will be 3, and 5 minus 2 will be 3, which is better than 4. So 5 minus 2 will be 3, and which is better than 4. So you remove this edge and you make this edge. This is what you have done. So here also what you have done, you have removed this edge, means 4, 2 plus 4 is 6. You have removed this 6 with this 6 minus 1 is 5. You have replaced with this. So this is what you have done. So this is what the shortest path from S. So this is how it worked. Node T is reachable with 2. Node X is reachable with 6. Node Y is reachable with 5 distance. Again, the node Z is reachable with 3 distance. This is what how you compute the shortest path in directed acyclic graph. Next, in the next class, we'll see Dijkstra's algorithm. So thanks all of you.
So, yes. So what was that topological sort in the initialization step of previous algorithm?
So that topological sort you have to study in the shorting. I hope that you had already studied that topological sort. It gives you the shorted order of that vertices in that, so that you can execute this for loop in efficient manner, so that it will reduce the complexity as V plus E. So for that,
sir, if we do not sort, then also we are doing V plus E.
No, that V plus E can't be done, because this step G dot adjacency of U would actually reduce the whole complexity to E. Otherwise, this will be having V plus V cross E. V cross E would be what? Larger than V cross E is larger than V plus E. But this doesn't happen at all because of topological sort. This is the importance of doing topological sort over here. Otherwise, if you remove this step, just remove this step and just do it, this thing, these three things, you will get V cross E. Why you do the first step as topological sort? So that you will get V plus E. Means whatever topological sort is taking runtime, it is the most expensive one. So I hope that it's...
So, sir, can you show once again, sir? Sir, in the step 3 to 5, sir, it is taking order V cross E. And sir, in the step 1, it is taking order V plus E. Sir, I was asking, sir, if we do not use the step 1, then also it will take order V cross E.
If we don't use the step 1, it will take V cross E. Here it is taking V plus E. Here.
So where?
When we take this, when we take this whole thing, when we do this topological sort, this relaxation would take only order of E, means it will take only the number of edges that's possible.
So, but outer for loop is taking order V and inner for loop is taking order E. So order V dot E for 3 and 4. And if we count relaxation for order E, then order V dot E dot E.
No, it's not like this. You just execute the first one, whichever be the shorted out in this algorithm. So that in this step also we had executed whatever be the shorted one. So that's the importance of shorting. If you don't have any shorted one, and this is actually order of R will be executed, then S would be executed, then T would be executed, then X would be executed, then Y would be executed, then Z would be executed. This is what you are getting from that step one. Otherwise, you take anything randomly, you will end up with more complexity. This is what I'm telling. this step you had already calculated in the step one. So this is, to calculate this you need V plus E. Because of this step you had calculated, this will result in only E. Relaxation would only take place E times.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, is there any other doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Thanks. We'll see Jasta's algorithm in the next class. Thanks. Bye.